data analysis and data science. Which one is easier and which one should you be looking to do to develop your career?
If you're new to this channel and you're keen to learn the latest tips, tricks, and tools for working more effectively with data, please hit the subscribe button for weekly videos.
So, first of all, there is a massive overlap between the things that you do in data analysis and data science. For instance, asking questions, finding relevant data, gathering that data, mashing it together, analyzing that data, and then presenting it are all common tasks done between both data analysis and data science. So then what's the difference between these two fields? Well, first of all, data analysts may be using tools as simple as Excel. Using things like VLOOKUPs and pivot tables is probably the kind of most entry level place that you can get in at when doing some data analysis type work. Now, when you're working as a data scientist, you are typically using much more sophisticated tools, things like R and Python. Now, a lot of the work is actually the same, and doing the same sort of data wrangling, data preparation, and all that sort of thing. But because you're using a programming tool instead of a tool such as Excel, the work is much more reproducible. You're able to handle much larger sets of data. You're able to do much more in-depth sort of visualizations that give you much more insight about the data instead of just the high-level summary statistics. You get access to much more libraries, such as machine learning and all those different kinds of things like that. Now, data analysts can also take advantage of a lot of these tools because aside from giving you access to some of the more data science-y tools, such as the stats tools and machine learning and all this kind of thing, they allow you to process more data faster than, say, Excel and SQL. It enables you to produce a reproducible process, which means that instead of doing an analysis piece of work, like one time, you design a process that you do one time, and then you can run it however many times that you want. So there's a really good kind of return on your time when you are using kind of data science tools as opposed to the more data analysis type tools. The other thing is that a lot of times with data analysis, you're looking at data that already exists, and you're basically doing reports and stats off data that's already there, which is basically descriptive analytics. Now, when you're looking into more data science-y kind of stuff, now you're looking to build models which you can predict outcomes on kind of more unknown data or new data that comes in. So this is using things like regression, machine learning, and different techniques like that, which enable you to predict the future. So which is easier? Data analysis is definitely easier. And it's very much the foundation for a lot of what you do in data science. 80% of what data scientists do is still data analysis type of work. And really, it's only the extra kind of 20% on top where they're getting to use a lot more kind of sophisticated machine learning techniques and all these kind of things. And the thing to keep in mind in here is that that 20% extra that they need to do probably takes 100 times more study as well than the data analysis type of work. So anybody who's interested in data, I would definitely recommend starting with data analysis type of work. There is so much of this work around because there's basically data everywhere. The data analysis type of work is definitely the type of thing that more people are familiar with. So you go into different organizations, there's already like tons of reporting teams and people doing different types of things with data. And as it stands today, a lot of this is really, really inefficient and really ineffective. There is something like 750 million Excel users in the world right now. And a lot of people don't realize that there's much more efficient ways for processing that data than the way that has been done for many, many years now. So That may include things like simply upgrading from traditional Excel models to using things like Power Query and Power Pivot, or taking a step further to using a more programming tool like R or Python, which is going to then be a much better stepping stone into some of the more data science-y type of stuff. Even if you never get to any of the predictive models or anything, you're still going to reap a ton of benefit because everything just runs so much faster. In Excel, where it starts to cap out at maybe, you know, 50,000 records or so, depending on your model, with something like R or Python, using exactly the same hardware, exactly the same machine, you'll probably be doing that same type of work on like 5 million records. And it's going to run even faster than your Excel model. You'll have access to more visualizations, and you'll have access to all the machine learning libraries. So it's a really good path you can go down if you start utilizing some of these tools. And you don't even need to use them all straight away either. Right, anyway, hope that helps. Found this useful, please leave a thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.